Ready to open the hood? Useful for the tutorials.
And for car parts, the right idea is the Mr. Auto app. Easy, fast, and with better prices than on the website.
You will find the bulk shock absorbers used in the video exclusively on the Mr. Auto website and through the link in the description. Turn your engine off, pull up the handbrake, pull on the bonnet release lever, and open the bonnet. To remove the front shock absorbers, you must lift the windscreen frame to get access to the shock absorber retaining nuts. Using a flathead screwdriver, remove the windscreen frame retaining rivet by lifting the central part. Then lift the windscreen. Tip: you don't need to remove the entire windscreen. You can hold it in the open position. Remove the protective cover from the strut mount fronts. As the components to be removed are very often seized up, don't hesitate to brush and to use penetrating oil to facilitate the operation. Using a 7mm Allen key and a 21mm offset wrench, unscrew the nut holding suspension strut support bearing by a few threads. You can also use the specific tool used in the video, which will make your task much easier. Loosen the stud bolts on the front wheels. Lift the front of the vehicle. We strongly suggest watching the tutorial Raising Your Vehicle Safely before carrying out this step. Place the vehicle on the axle stands. You must remove the wheels in order to change the front shock absorbers on your car. This will give you full access to the suspension system. Don't forget to slide them under the vehicle. During this operation, you will be working on the front axle of your car, so it's advisable to perform a parallelism afterwards. Ask someone to press the brake to prevent the disc and drivetrain from rotating. Next, using a breaker bar and an M36 triple square socket, loosen the drivetrain nut by a few threads. Finish the unscrewing process with the help of the socket wrench. You now have to remove the upper bolt from the sway bar link. To do this, take a 17mm spanner and a 5mm Allen key. Stop the rotation with the Allen key and remove the nut using the spanner. Using a flathead screwdriver, remove the brake hose retaining clip. Remove the brake hose from its housing. Remove the ABS sensor cable. Using a socket wrench, an 18mm socket, a breaker bar and an M14 triple square socket, unscrew the nut holding the shock absorber base. Then remove the bolt. You can spread the opening of the stub axle using the special socket used in the video, which will make your job much easier. Prepare a stable elevated surface to place all the stub axle once you've removed it. Remove the drive shaft from the hub, then place the stub axle assembly on the previously installed jack. Finish unscrewing the suspension strut support bearing nut. Hold the shock absorber with one hand and finish unscrewing with the other. Remove the shock absorber. In order to change the shock absorber, you must now separate it from the spring. You can find the description of the tool we used in the video, which we think is most adapted to the operation. Careful! Pay attention as you compress the spring. This is not without risk and should be undertaken paying very careful attention. Install the shock absorber on the tool, then tighten the mobile flange against the spring, controlling its position carefully. Check that they're properly held by the locking studs, then slowly compress the spring using the socket wrench and the appropriate socket. Once the shock absorber is free in the spring, you can use a 21mm offset wrench and a 7mm Allen key to unscrew the suspension strut support bearing. You can also use the specific tool used in the video, which will make your task much easier. In the most extreme cases, you have to use an impact wrench. Then remove the suspension strut support bearing assembly. remove the shock absorber from the spring.
Okay, guys, if we can share this video with you and help you save a lot of money, is also thanks to our partner, Mr. Auto. So, if you want to support us and buy the part for this operation, visit their website. Okay, back to work.
You will find the bulk shock absorbers used in the video exclusively on the Mr. Auto website and through the link in the description. Before installing the new shock absorbers, it is necessary to prime them by pressing the shock absorber rod vertically so that the gas and the hydraulic fluid are separated. Unscrew the lock nut on the stem. Place the stop in the sleeve. Position everything in the spring. Then place the assembly on the damper rod. Then install the upper shock absorber support, the turning stop plate, the shock absorber mount, and finish by screwing the nut on the shock absorber mount. Tightly fix in place using a 21mm offset wrench while holding the stem with a 7mm Allen key. Pay careful attention to place the bottom of the spring so that it supports the shock absorber flange. Unscrew the spring compression tool, paying attention to the position of the spring on the lower shock absorber support. You have now finished preparing the new part. Insert the shock absorber starting from the top part. Put the upper support bearing back in place, then screw the nut holding the strut mount front back on by hand first. Grease the shock absorber base. Thread the shock absorber base into the stub axle. The lower position and pin of the shock absorber base must be inserted into the opening of the axle stub until the tap of the pin allows the axle stub screw to pass through. Then reinstall the shock absorber foot screw. Start to screw the nut in a little. Remove the special socket. Insert the drive shaft into the stub axle. Reinstall the suspension ball joint in the control arm. Screw in the three nuts holding the control arm on the ball joint and finish tightening with a torque wrench. Screw the foot of the screw back into the shock absorber. Finish up the tightening with a torque wrench. Put the sway bar link back in place. Finish off the tightening with the torque wrench. Clip the ABS sensor hose back in. Reinstall the brake hose. Then lock it. Roughly screw the drivetrain nut back on. Ask someone to press the brake pedal. Finish off the tightening with the torque wrench. Then add the recommended clamping angle using the paint marker technique to confirm the correct angle. Then you will be able to put the wheels back on your vehicle. Put the car back on the ground. Lock the wheel securely. Finish screwing the nut on the shock absorber head. Finish off the tightening with the torque wrench. Put the rubber protection back in place. Put the windscreen bay back in place. Then lock it with a rivet. Operation completed.
Hi, it's Theo from Usetool. I hope this video has helped you a lot in your car maintenance. We would be super grateful if you could spread the word so that we can produce even more tutorials. Simply give us a like, a comment, and hit that subscribe button. It really helps us boost the channel and help the whole community. Thanks a lot and have a great one.